Hello everyone, I'm Knee-High Caliber, and you're watching another exciting episode of Knee-High Caliber Plays War Thunder. And today, we are back at Henderson Field. We're going to be going up in present for you. Just got a new standardized roundel paint job. Pretty nice. So we're going to be taking her into the sky for a little anti-submarine patrol. We're the closest available patrol aircraft currently. No big deal. It's not really the use for one of these, but I guess it's not too different from a Catalina or some other kind of patrol plane. It's a big one, I forget. But anyway, we're going to set flaps to take off, and we're going to get up in the air. We already have clearance. We've been waiting for 2 minutes now. Let's get this thing in the air. 60% power. Max power. Tails up. Rotate. Gear up. Retract flaps. Wonder what that is. Is that on the other side of the mountain? It's there. They're probably target vehicles. I know they're field training, yeah. The Australians are field training their pilots. Yeah, they're German, so Dutch acquired. So we actually shouldn't go too high for this operation. We'll keep it under the only thing we have are conventional bombs, so we can try and hit them. I have the bomb bay controls set to individually drop the bombs, so that should be fine. I think they're maybe 500 pounders, 250 pounders each. Got eight of them. Small payload. These things are designed to bomb in groups. Were they designed to bomb in groups? Now that I'm thinking about it, it's, curious. Yeah, because of the fortress concept, the box firing concept. Still nothing. It's gonna be hard to spot this even from up here. Oh, we went to 2,000. What else is on the controls? Alright. So basically, Fleet Intelligence reported a Japanese mothership submarine in the area carrying mini subs. Attack subs. They go by another name this time. But anyway. Anyway, if there's a sub in this area carrying those things, there could be possibly two or four, or just one, or, you know, the mothership and the mini sub. Any anti-sub control, I would check out the little estuaries and such. You never know when you might see something. I'd also need some trees and hammocks. A lot of flooding in this area. Water's so clear, you can see. I don't see anything. We'll find that submarine. Or submarines. So the mini subs only have two torpedoes. The big subs basically have either a full or half complement. Basically just got the ball gunner and the bombardier searching the waves. Yeah, default leveling out is not leveling out because the plane is still flying. So if you really want to level, you have to take manual control. I mean, the plane has an autopilot, but don't really see the need for one in War and Thunder. Unless you want to go, like, make a burrito in the microwave while you go, and I guess you could just leave it on the path and hope your gunner just get it, but it jumps you. If you want to. I just wanted to do that. I probably should be closer to the coast there. That's okay. That was weird. That wasn't a submarine, though. That was an underwater feature. Something like that. They would get this close to the beach. Usually, if they do, they kind of end up like a whale. It's kind of beached up on there. That's pretty much how they captured a few early on in the war. Pearl Harbor. Attack on Pearl Harbor. That's how they knew about the submarines. That's how they caught one of the guys, too. I think the captain was dead, or his torpedo man was dead. Captured the captain. Not the captain, but the captain. But, you know, who's a captain, of the ship. Sea tradition. What is that?
What is that?
You saw that. Disappeared, too. That was weird. That was like a... That looked like a dragon. What the hell was that? Okay. Was it an artifact, maybe? I'm not gonna rule that out, but I'm almost certain it was red. This is weird. That looked like a dragon. I mean, I can justify dropping a few bombs, because honestly, yeah. Max power. Scare it up or hurt it. I don't know what it is. It could be a submarine. Whoa, banging. Heavy banging. Alright, I'm just gonna go for that big old spot. Two bombs. I mean, it's kind of funny because I'm playing a game, and it's more probable that this actually is a sea monster as some kind of Easter egg. Alright, I'm not going to waste the rest of my bombs. There's nothing there. But yeah, in the actual situation, it's really like sequence. Alright, let's continue. Max power, let's get that. That was weird. Don't give me that look. I know what I saw. Alright, we're coming up on this chain. There's a lot of codes around here, so this might take... Plot of land somebody's picked out. Let's keep descending. And, come on. Flaps up. 79%. sec. Oh crap. We're flooding. Again, if it comes this close to shore, it's pretty screwed. I go through the river there. Yeah, at some point, since we're stationed here for a little while longer, I might do another guidance flight around this area. I think that would be useful. I don't know if you'd want to get a submarine and head up this room. I mean, it's doable. Stay in the middle, which is again. They mostly operate at periscope depth, so they should be around. I don't think they can go very deep. I don't think the mother submarine is in this river. Maybe. Doubtful. This is really tight. I really want to know what the hell that thing was. Yeah, two loggings over there. So we'll just fly past two logging. There's a chance it's probably over here. Because they don't go hiding. They use them in an attack. So maybe they didn't even deploy it yet. We just know it's in the area. Might have had something to do with that thing that we saw. Somewhere around here is, I mean, there's a lot of wrecks, but somewhere around here is a wildcat that went in during the marine landings. That was back in August or something. But yeah, they took out a whole bunch of seaplanes there. Wonder if that guy made it. Crashed. Yeah, we'll come back around up here. Here's the village. just gonna point out, I mean, I don't think that's an isolated village anymore. A tribal village. But, yeah, there were tribes on islands like this who would see planes like this in the sky and assume the gods would to deliver. Well, in most cases, they looked up and transported these. They're called, they kind of became, cargo cults. You don't think of that effect. Alright. I don't think there's anything in that. Let's check it out. Anchor. Oh yeah, cargo cults. They would build mock-ups of airfields out of wicker and bamboo. And they'd sit in little control towers. I'm not even kidding about this. This actually is a thing. And, you know, pretty sad. But, yeah. You know, like somebody living down in there might look up and see this plane flying in the sky. They don't know what the plane is, and this thing's huge. Back to base. We've been flying for over 20 minutes now. 25 minutes. More. I mean, we got enough fuel here. But, yeah. Where is my fuel gauge anyway? Where is it? Fuel. Okay, it's not even a half. If that's functioning, I hope it's functioning. Well, anyway, this was only to cover the morning patrol. Ugh, I need some more coffee, damn it. Australians are providing us with targets. I mean, it's theirs, so whatever. Yeah, I want to thank you for joining me. Please don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and hit the bell for notifications. I am the High Caliber. You've been watching the High Caliber play some War Thunder. Sign off there. I just heard a plane fly by. Also, those two Australian bombers that collided with each other, I don't know where their wreckage is. Somewhere off the bases there. There. I don't know. graveyards of war. Tanks, planes, like ditches, underwater canyons. Flaps to landing. For it. I guess I can fly over the field. Kind of scout out the wind socket that's there, but man, actually work. I don't know. We will see. Almost looks like it lost the tip. Tip there. Like it's smaller than it should be. I don't know, we'll stop it on the ground, we'll see. I'm in the wind. I landed in the wind. Flaps up. Oh, now I see it. That's weird. Yeah, whatever. Alright, folks. Thanks for joining me. Catch you later.